Well, good morning, boys and girls. It's Uncle Aaron again. And Merry Christmas. I hope you've enjoyed your Christmas holidays. Today, we're going to begin with our action memory verse, followed by the Bible story time, and then we'll finish with the Bible's own praise song. Are you ready to get started? Okay, here we go. Our action memory verse for today is from the book of Psalms, chapter 46, verse 1. And it says, God is our refuge. That means the safe place that we can go to for help, for protection. So it says, God is our refuge and strength, always ready to help in times of trouble. So let's do that together now with the actions, all right? I want you to stand up and get ready to do this. So let's say Psalms chapter 46, verse 1. And we're going to say, God is our refuge and strength, always ready to help in times of trouble. Okay, boys and girls, I want you to remember that God is always there, ready to help, no matter what you're going through. You can always pray to Him. Last week's video was called God Parted the Red Sea. Let's see what happens in this week's video.
When sin entered the world after Adam and Eve rebelled, God made an important promise. God promised a rescuer would come from Eve's family. As years passed, God's people waited for him to keep his promise. God sometimes spoke to his people through prophets and prophetesses, men and women who received a message from God and then told it to the people. The prophet Isaiah shared a message about God's promise to send a rescuer. The rescuer would be called the Messiah, which means anointed one or chosen one. This is what Isaiah wrote. The people are living in darkness now, but they will see a great light. A light will shine on them. God will grow the nation and give the people joy. People will rejoice like they do at harvest time or after a war is won. This is how God will keep his promise. A child will be born for us, a son will be given to us, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Eternal Father, Prince of Peace. All these names tell us who Jesus is and the great things that he would do. Jesus was coming to earth to help people and to protect people. Jesus would be a king who cares about his people, and he would bring peace to the whole world. Isaiah also said, his kingdom will be full of his power and peace. The kingdom will grow, and he will reign on the throne as the king. He will be a good, fair, and loving king who reigns forever. God keeps his promises. He remembered his promise to send a rescuer and sent his son Jesus into the world as a baby. Jesus grew up and provided salvation for sinners by dying on the cross and rising from the dead.
Today's story happened many years after Moses and the Israelites left Egypt and crossed the Red Sea. To help the people remember his promises, God sent prophets to speak to them. Today we saw the prophet Isaiah, and he spoke about the Messiah, the chosen one, who would come to rescue people from sin. So God always keeps his promises, and one of the first promises was to Adam and Eve. After they sinned and messed everything up, he promised that he would send a rescuer to save all of humanity from our sin. And then we saw that he promised Abraham that he would have a family, a really big family, and that God would make them into a great nation, and that all of the world will be blessed through his family. And then we also saw that God promised to be with Moses and the Israelites as they were coming out of slavery in Egypt. And he did that in an amazing way. And again, Isaiah was talking about the promised Messiah. And we all just celebrated Christmas. That is an exciting time where we spend it with family. We have lots of food and fun and maybe some gifts in there. That's really cool, and we can enjoy all of that. But what Christmas is really celebrating is the most amazing promise that God fulfilled, which means He followed through with that promise. He promised to send someone to rescue us from our sin, and He did. He sent Jesus all those years ago. Jesus is God. He's always lived forever in heaven, but He came to earth as a baby and He grew up and He taught us lots of stuff. But then He died on the cross. He took the punishment that you and I deserved for our sin, and He rose again from the dead. And so when we celebrate Christmas, there's lots of cool things we can enjoy, but the main thing that we're celebrating is that God kept His most amazing promise to send Jesus to rescue us from our sin. So we can always rely on God's promises. Now, you might think about this and ask the question, what do I do if a person makes a promise to me and then they break that promise? They don't keep the promise. That's a good question. And that does happen in life sometimes, and when it happens, it can really hurt us and upset us, right? Have you ever had that happen to you, where someone promised you something and then they broke that promise? Here's what I want to tell you. Sometimes that can happen because life can be a little crazy, and someone might make a promise to you and they might mean to follow through and to keep that promise, but then something happens and they're not able to. So first of all, I would say that you should have grace. That means patience and understanding for that person. Okay, that should be the first thing. The second thing is that if they have hurt us, we can let them know, but when we do, it has to be done with a heart that still loves that person and is kind to them, not one that says, you broke that promise and you hurt me, so I'm gonna hurt you back. That would not be what God wants for us. And the other thing is that we have to remember that God is the only one that we can really trust all the time. So, you know, we have parents, we have adults, we have friends who might make promises, and sometimes they keep those promises. Sometimes things happen and they might not. Well, we just have to understand that the main one that we can always rely on is God, because He's faithful and He always keeps His promises. So I'd like to close with this question. How does it make you feel to know that God always keeps His promises? Well, boys and girls, it's time for our Bible Zone praise song. So we can celebrate and sing and dance and have some fun and do some actions to the song that we're going to do today. And that song is How Far Love Goes. This song reminds us that Jesus gave it all up to come to earth, to live amongst us, to suffer, and to die for our sins, take the punishment that we deserve. And He did that because of how much He loves us. So let's remember that as we sing this song, How Far Love Goes.
How deep, how high, how long, and how
Well, boys and girls, I hope you enjoyed that song. Now, before we close in our prayer, I want to remind you, if you have any questions at all about anything you saw or heard today, or anything you might want to know about God or the Bible, you can email them to me at the email address below, but make sure you get Mom or Dad's permission first. All right, let's close our eyes so we don't get distracted. We're going to pray to God. Let's pray. Dear God, I thank you that you are faithful and you always keep your promises, and we can rely on you all the time. Even when things go bad in life, you're always there for us. Help us to remember your promises, to study them in the Bible so that we can understand who you are, how much you love us, and the truth that you're always there for us. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Boys and girls, thank you so much for watching today's video. And remember, God always keeps his promises because he's faithful. I'll see you next week.